170 UW students studying abroad in Italy are packing their bags and heading back home.
The university suspended the program Friday after a jump in coronavirus cases in Italy. Our Amanda Quintana spoke to a student in Rome and is here with more. Amanda?
Students were scheduled to spend a whole 4 months in Italy, but that was all cut short after just 2 months. A bitter ending for students who have been saving money and planning this trip for a long time.
I still feel so safe here. However, I'm definitely worried about coming home.
Although it's been hard for UW junior Molly Davis to accept that her semester in Italy is over, her time there cut in half by coronavirus concerns.
It had the potential to be so amazing because it's immersed into the city and you get to see so much of it. Then again, if something like this happens, it's all taken away.
Now she's focused on what happens next before she's let back into the U.S.
My best guess is that we're going to be screened for fevers, and anyone with a fever will be stopped. I also wouldn't be surprised if there's a recommended self-quarantine, but I would be surprised if I wasn't allowed to leave the airport. That would be something that I wouldn't expect.
Davis, her boyfriend, and friends are just a few of the 170 UW students who went to Italy for the food, the culture, the history, now being told they have to come home. Once the travel notice to Italy was upgraded to a warning level 3, their program was canceled. Now 18 more deaths reported there in just 24 hours, and the total coronavirus cases exceeding 2,000.
Health and safety is the biggest concern, but I can't ignore the disappointment that I have. A lot of my best friends are also abroad this semester, studying in different countries, studying in Spain and Germany.
While those students get to stay, those in Italy are coming back to apartments they've already subleased, thinking of the money, unsure if they'll get refunded.
UW officials are also unsure what the next step is for their students. They will be able to finish the course online, though. Davis says that just won't be the same as walking around in Rome.
Yeah, no doubt. Not quite the same as experiencing in person. Amanda, thank you.